Hello, welcome to another pike fishing videos with the King Piker. Today we're fishing in O'Brien's Bridge and we're going to be using smelt and we have dead perch as well. I'm just setting up a rig now, putting on the stop net. I'm going to have one on the bottom. I'm going to have a smelt. My friend Glenn is going to be fishing a float and a bit of smelt about 7 or 8 feet off the bottom. So, the weather's not on our side, is it, Glenn?
Nope.
It is known for big pike or O'Brien's Bridge, but it's a lot of fucking Eastern Europeans have been fished out and they're killing all the pike. And what we do if we catch them, Glenn?
Throw them back.
No, the Eastern Europeans.
We'll eat them.
We'll fuck them in. Oh, I'm just getting on this cap right now so I can pop this up. It's like middle fucking man. About to hold it. Where's that leader, Glenn?
Here, have it here.
Good man. It's a simple, it's a very, very simple setup. And you can catch your many, many fish if you do it right. My next video I'm going to go up in the dinghy. We might go to the far side over there, it's known for big pike as well.
I'd say it's a whole lap for an hour, nearly 2 hours.
Stay with me now, lad. Stay with me. Oh, and we might also get a bit of a few live bait as well. And the maggots and the small. Wag the float in the smaller, lad. Right. Time for the trace. Got it. Got the hooks. I made these myself the other day, the handy ones. Size 4 red trebles, leaves as well. And cover your crimps. Give it nice and neat. You know what I'm going to do now? These are the simplest poppers that you could use. Just attach them onto your trace and away with you. I'm going to have to move down these. There you have it. One simple rig for a pop up. No. What we're gonna do now, I'm gonna put on our dead bait and hope we get a pike. We have our bucket. Wait, I might.
Some pong off him.
That's what you need for the pike.
What is
this? Just a pollock. It's a pollock. I never put a pollock on the bottom before, so I'm just gonna chance it and see. Never know.
For a little chance.
You never know what a pike fancies. Now lads, I'm only starting off with these videos for YouTube and I've I've caught a lot of pike out here. But it is known you could fish this bank for 2 to 3 weeks without even catching a pike. This is a bit small.
Back it in.
Put one in here. And I'm going to put one right in the back there. So he's going to be popped up. Either way, he's going to be popped up and he's going to be sitting pretty.
Ready to go.
And as you can see, I have to stop that. This is the way I think it works, and the way I would normally fish it. I have the stop knot there, I have the lead ball. So it's going to pop up, it's going to come up. Your lead ball. That's how much it's going to. There's the bottom. When it pop up, it's going to come up about 2 to 3 feet off the bottom. But I'm going to fish it down to about a foot and a half, two foot off the bottom.
It's like a fucking stone.
We have the new rod. Got the other there. The new rod.
Very loud, isn't it?
No.
There's one. Set up, lads. No. I'm gonna have one smelt under the float. This is the metal I prefer to use. It's been a lot of pike. Subscribe to my channel, lads. King of Pike. More fishing videos as we go along with the baby piker, the prodigy Glenn, and Wayne's not here today, but he'll be fishing with us during the week.